Yes, Angelo?
Mom? Is Ina my dad's mistress?
Huh? What did you say? Who's Ina?
Mommy cried to me about her. She works at Casa Corazon, the one with the handkerchief.
Oh, that Ina.
You know, Angelo, to be perfectly honest,
I would love to tell you that she is the one, but I don't have any evidence to prove their relationship.
But Mom...
Angelo, I have my hands full with so many things. I'm dealing with our business matters. You should just get used to your father's ways. They come and go.
So you're not sure about it?
Does it really matter who they are? You know, Angelo, that's the least of my concerns now. A fierce kingdom woman today, but a dark one tomorrow. Okay? Bye, Angelo.
Okay, this one's finished. I'll leave the rest with you. Oh, how many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Okay.
There's 7 in all.
Oh, no, it's no problem. Anything for you, Mr.
You already know who to give them to.
Yes, of course I do.
Thank you.
Isko?
Oh, yes, Belen. What's that? What is it?
I was supposed to give this to you yesterday, oh. But it was only delivered today. Happy birthday again, Isko.
Oh, thank you. I'm going to open it now.
Sure.
Let's see what it is. Oh, this is so nice. Look.
Wow, Mr. Isko. That shirt looks really nice. I'm sure it will look perfect on you.
Oh, can you see if it will fit me?
Okay.
Hold it for me. I'll put it on my back and check.
It's a perfect
Hello,
fit,
Antonio.
Mr. Isko. I'm sure once you put this on, you'll look
I'm sorry
even
to
more
bother you,
than you already are.
But I don't have anyone else to turn to about Kaloy's situation.
No problem. Anything for my nephew.
So, is there any news about him?
Why are you always around, Ina? And you really came all the way here just to ask
what
me that?
What does Ina have to do in Dad's office?
That's none of your business, Angela.
That business is my father, so stop protecting him.
Ah, and you're thinking that I'm the pimp for your father and Ina, right? That's what's on your mind, right? You are so narrow-minded, Angelo.
Then tell me right now, what's going on between you?
This is about the gambling issue, and nothing more. I won't get into the details. It doesn't concern you. Aha. I forgot it is your concern. If you hadn't been caught in that gambling den, collecting money with those criminals, the governor would never be in this mess. Sir, I'll help Mark in contacting the people we need to talk to. But sir, I hope it's okay if I ask to be dismissed earlier today.
David, something's obviously bothering you. Does this have anything to do with Angelo? I saw you talking to him.
I'm sorry, Governor, but I'm losing my patience with your son.
Why? What happened?
Adam? Tammy and Gabby, Sir Miguel says that you have to be here tomorrow to help us out. Is that
yes,
clear?
Yes, Chef Jen. I will do anything for you.
I've emailed you the revised menu. I want to have the mock-up copies by tomorrow morning, okay?
But it doesn't mean you can neglect your work, okay?
Thank you.
Yes. I want everyone to be busy. Mm-hmm. Tony.
Of course.
Chef Jen.
Okay, you.
What's going on here?
Oh, Sir Angelo, I'm just relaying Sir Miguel's instructions to them. We couldn't do this earlier because we had a customer.
Oh, okay.
Okay, any other questions?
When will you give me a chance, Chef Jen?
Oh, don't be silly.
I'm just kidding,
Make him
Chef
stop,
Jen.
Will you? Okay, Tony, tomorrow.
No problem.
Bye, sir.
Kim. Will you wash this for me, please?
Ina?
Yes,
Ina,
Chef?
Kindly fill this up with water so we can start boiling the meat. When you're done with that,
yes,
wash
chef.
This.
Here you go. Wash this, too.
Yes, sir.
Tony, where are my other herbs? Huh?
I have them right here.
Excuse me.
Oh, dear.
Chef Jen?
Yes, sir.
I'd like to order some food.
Order?
I need something for 20 people. I'll pay for it.
What for? Sir, Tony and I would be more than happy to cook for you. You own this place.
No, it's a personal order, so charge it on me.
Chef Jen, the meat is ready.
Okay, start boiling it. Well, what will we cook?
I'll leave it to you.
Chef Tony, I've finished washing this.
Bring it here. Here.
Chef Jen.
Okay.
Chef Jen, look, Sir Angelo's up to something.
Put it there.
He's setting up a videoke machine.
Okay, that's good.
I don't know.
Thank you. Chef Jen?
Yes, sir?
I need your help.
Oh, Chef Jen!
Okay. What's the occasion?
Oh, I really don't know, Sir Scott. Sir Angelo just asked me to bring you here.
Sir Angelo?
Yes. Oh, wait, where's Ma'am Belen?
Oh, she said she had to go somewhere.
I wanted to ask her about the recipe she used for the birthday party yesterday. Oh. Ta-da!
What? Oh, is it my birthday again?
Surprise!
Surprise!
Hey, everyone is here!
Happy birthday!
Happy birthday! Wait a minute, tell me, whose idea was this?
It was Sir Angelo's!
Sir Angelo?
You never mentioned what Sir Angelo did to you exactly. But it's very clear that he is trying to make it up to you. So this is a repeat performance of Sir Isko's birthday since you missed it yesterday.
Really?
Huh?
Thank you.
No, I just dreamed about it. Is it wrong? It's what I usually see on TV. I'm not going to ask you anymore about what you did to Ina. What matters is that you're sorry.
Miguel, it was our employee's birthday. And it's only normal that we should throw them a party so that they'll be happier at work.
Shut up. Sir Scott, happy birthday!
Thank you, sir. Come, happy join birthday. Us. Oh, someone please
hey,
give him a plate.
Sir Miguel a plate.
Sir Angelo, thank you so much.
Sir Scott, happy birthday, sir.
What is this for, Sir Angelo?
It's a little birthday present from the management. We wanted to show your appreciation.
Oh, I won't refuse this, Sir Angelo. I'm really thankful to you for this. Thank you so much.
Hey, Sir Angelo. All of us are hardworking too.
That's yes. right, sir.
Well, on your birthdays then.
Oh, my birthday's
sir,
coming
really?
Up.
We'll get a gift.
Of course.
Oh. We'll get a
this
gift.
This is going to be a big help.
That's good.
Red, here, have some more rice.
Able to save this,
did mother yes. tell you what time she'll be back home?
No, way. She didn't.
Have some more.
Okay.
Belen, does your husband know that you've come to me asking for advice?
You know him, Antonio. Isko will get mad at me for sure if he finds out that I came to you for help.
So my brother hasn't changed after all this time. You know, the problem with him is that he's too straight-laced. What use is that in times like this? What then?
That's why I've come to you. I summoned my courage to ask for your help, even though he told me that I should never tell you about Kaloy's situation. But I feel that the longer we sit around doing nothing, the sooner your nephew will give up and crawl closer to his grave.
What is the point in my being a major if I can't do anything to help you, okay? Who's the chief of police in your district?